Hi, my name is Subramaniam Jayaram Supu. I am a EBS Cloud Functional Consultant. So today I would like to explain how the VMI process will work in cloud system. So VMI process is very simple and seamless integration between the buying organization and the supplier portals. So in this session, I would like to use the existing legal entity, business unit, inventory, supplier contact, and even for the login, couple of login user IDs. And I'll show you that how, what are the roles we need to assign for the supplier contact when the supplier want to release the replenishment request, or you want to go for update the min-max value is based on the past supply and demand values. So quickly we'll create an item in the system. So go to product information management. I'm using a SEM00.instructor. I have provided enough roles for this user. I'm going into this product management system. So product management, PIM, product information management, and go to create items. And I'm using a Vision Instant Cloud, I mean the Oracle Vision Instance. So 00 is my master org, is a Vision master org. And I'm going to create an item from this existing one. And then I have an item called HP8001. This is the existing Oracle seated item. I'm going to use the same. So click OK. Click OK. And then here I have to give this my item, like S21 VMI item one. Or I can give something S21. Yeah, this is my starting indicator, S21 VMI item. And I can give the same item here too, and or I can give the item two, because item one I'm already using it. So two, and then go back, all attributes copied from this existing part, go to specifications, and then go for the planning system, planning tab, and make sure that this inventory planning method should be supplier managed. This is the only thing it will drive. This part is a VMI part or min-max part, min-max planning part or reorder point planning part. So we'll see later about in future sessions about how the min-max plan and the reorder point planning. First, we'll think about, we'll talk more about this supplier managed ones. So once you're done, and make sure that the minimum and maximum quantity should be applied in 96-240, and then click save. 96-240 is my minimum and my maximum quantity. I'll go and assign this part to my child args. I'm going to take my child arg as HC01. HC01 is my inventory arg, the existing inventory arg, cloud, I mean vision inventory arg, which I'm taking. Click OK. So once done, click save. And click save and close. So there is a concurrent program which we need to run. Normally in production, it will be scheduled frequently based on how much the parts and transactions happening between the buying organization and the vendor. So accordingly, this will be scheduled in production. Right now, for our testing purpose, I'm running that program manually, okay? So when you want to run any scheduled program, go to tools, schedule request, schedule process. I have, this is the refresh VMI replenishment data. And keep the cursor here and go the same program and just click the resubmit. Once you're done, I'll wait for a couple of minutes, let's complete. And so meantime, so I'll go into this vendor side, and I'm going to see that part whether it's interfaced or not, okay? So going into vendor manage inventory, I have logged into the different browser. So I'm going here. This Jamie Ryan is my vendor contact person. So I'll move in this supplier portal. You have enough access for that. I will show you that what roles I have assigned for this guy. And here you can see this is a vendor manage inventory. We'll see later in future sessions how the contract manufacturing and other PM, I mean the I supplier like ACE and ASPN and all works. So we'll consider more about this vendor manage inventory now. So you just click the manage inventory one. So once you click the manage inventory one, it's a So once you're going to the manage inventory tab, where you can see all your part numbers for the is coming. So this is the one which I already tested before going to the session, but unfortunately S21 BMI item 2 didn't came here. We'll see why it didn't came here. Go back again, go to home. I'm in the supplier contact login. Go to supplier portal. Before coming to the supplier portal, let me go into, there's a one configuration we need to do. I just missed it, and go to buying organization SCM001 instructor. Go to supply chain planning. There is some supply chain collaboration. So this is the collaboration which we need to set between the buying organization and the supplier portal. Then only the data will seamlessly tightly integrate between the buying organization and the supplier portal, whatever we are giving here. So go here, and there's a taskbar, and go, there is a manage BMI network. This is the one which mandatorily we need to provide. That's the reason that data didn't flow into supplier portal. So I'm giving to manage BMI network. Once you give a manage BMI network, there's a create, and I give this organization. HC01 is my inventory org. This is all inventory specific. And who is the supplier? So supplier is my BD Medical. The scope is organization level or subunit level. We can go with both. Either if you want to go for subunit level replenishment or the org level replenishment. I'll go for org level replenishment. And I'll give my part number S21 BMI item 2. There's an item 2. And then the source is I'm providing a supplier, min-max quantity update controlled by the supplier, because the supplier knows, supplier have their own planning system. They already knows how much, what is the minimum, what is the maximum quantity need to set based on the fast history, how much they ship to the buying organization. So again, this will be taken care between the negotiation between the supplier and the buying organization, whether who need to control the min and max values. But there's no hard and fast rule here. Even if you give the control to the supplier, even planner can also control the min and max value of the item level. They can do that from buying organization. But I'm giving you as a supplier. And then if you want to have any default requesters, you can provide that. I'll give some default requesters. So that way seamlessly request will get approved. So this is my requester, the existing one which I'm giving. Click save and control, save and close. So this is the one which was set here, done. Now again, once you set the VMI network, go back again, rerun this VMI replenishment data to push the data from buying organization to vendor portal. So make sure that, wait for some time, let it complete. I'm sure I think it will not take much time because this is the only one record I'm pushing from here to there. So it's ready, running, complete, normal. Then I'm going into this vendor portal. Jenny Ryan is my vendor contact person for this BD Medicals. I'll go for manage inventory. And you can see here, S21 VMI item 2 came here, right? So, and this is the very amazing portal which the buyer can able, I mean the supplier can see what is on and exist in the buying organization, what is the, how much stock, and it colorfully, because if there is no enough stock, it will show as a red color. And the same way what it can do means if you want add more fields, you can go and add columns. You can a lot of fields here, pending acknowledgement, on-hand quantity, buyer, who is the buyer, inventory planning, owner, who is the planner, owner, all the fields, if you required, you can add those fields here, right? So status name. So there are many fields you can add it here, right? So I'm not adding any field to make sure that, because I want to show what is on-hand, replenishment quantity, purchase order quantity, everything here. For this item, we'll take care of this. And green means the buying or enough stock. Yellow means excess stock. Red means very low stock. Now you can see this, nothing is showing here. There's no barrier. What is my on-hand? What is my on-hand order quantity? Nothing is showing here, because you can see here, my on-hand quantity 0, my replenishment quantity 0, purchase order quantity 0, go a little bit right, and you can see there is no min and max set, because I set my min and max value at master level R, and it was not flowed to my child.hc01. So I want to set my min and max value. There are some scenarios I'm giving full control to my supplier A. I don't know what is my min and max. I'm not following that. I'm taking very light. You take care of the business process, everything. So whenever, because until and my requirement is, I don't want to lose any data. So always the stock should be, enough stock should be exist in my inventory side. So you take the responsibility for the controlling the inventory. So then supplier is agreed. Yes, I will control your inventory. He will, what he will do means he'll take the fast data history. I mean, the supply and demand, he will control it. He will update and min-max values. So now I'm the supplier side, Jamie, Rayan. So keep this cursor here, go to actions. Oops, go to action here. If you want update min and max values, there is something called functionality you can upload. For example, one record, you can manually go and enter it. If you have 100 records, 200 records, 300 parts came and you want to update, or there is existing parts instead of this min and max values, you want to update other values. So in that case, what you can do means you can go to select all the records. You can keep cursor here in the corner. You can select all the records and then you can upload it. I'm going here. This record only, I'm going worry about it. And keep the cursor in the top actions. Go to upload min max quantities. So it'll open another window. There's only one. This is the old one. And I'm going to download my template. This is the download template. Once you download template, on what basis you want to upload? I want to based on my items. Click OK and give your item S21 VMI item 2. Select, click OK. And that template was downloaded. Open the template. And this is my template. So let me extend this. And it came, my supplier, my organization, my item all came. I don't want to get any subordinate because I'm maintaining my stock min and max at my organization level. So this is optional field. So give here the min and max 96 and 250 something, whatever. Like here you can give 100, right? 100 and 250 is my minimum is 100 and maximum is 250. Save. Yes, close it. Save. Yes, and then go back again here. There is something called upload. It's very simple process. Even there's no AD, web AD, ADF ID, it's less than that. So choose the file where you save. This is my file, which I downloaded min max quantities, and then click submit. Within a fraction of a second, the data will get updated. This is the amazing functionality which I'm seeing here now. So click okay. And you can see a success. If it's failed, you can review the record log file and you can see why it got failed on. Okay. Now come back again here. I'm sorry, not here. Go back here. Something called like done. Go here, refresh, search. And you can go for item, or I just went for org level search, SC01, because I want to show all the different items, different coloring statuses, everything, right? So click search. Once you go for click search, and you can see the bar came now, right? My on end is zero is showing, on order is showing is zero. So go back again here, little bit right. You can see 100 and 250. So successfully have the supplier has updated min and max values for you. Now the supplier is a new part. There's a minimum is 100. The buying organization requested, hey, please ship the 100 quantity as soon as possible, replenish it, or 50 quantity or 60 quantity, 20 quantity based on the supplier capacity plan, right? For example, you want to ship around, right now you want to ship 70 quantity. Think that way, okay? Go here, select this line, go to actions, and go to create replenishment request. This is the first one. Click it and give the supply site corporate. This is my supply site. Once you give the supply site, I want how much quantity I want, because this quantity will be decided based on, even though my minimum quantity is 100, but as of today, delivery date is today, the supplier don't have any capacity to ship that material under quantity, but it has only shipped only 70. So select 70, and you can give note whatever you want, like a VMI item, test by. Okay, click submit. Once you submit, within a fraction of a second, the request goes submitted. You can see here, this is red color. The reason is my minimum is 100. So the 70 is less than 100, and still I didn't reach my minimum level expectation. That's the reason it's showing is a red color. That's the indication to the even vendor, right? So then I'll go back again. I'll see what is my status of this request, okay? And you can see here also, replenishment quantity 70, right? And you can see there is no, if any PO got created, it will show the PO quantity. If it is a PO is received, it will show the unearned quantity. And then if you go in transit, for example, I'll show you that one by one, I'll come back, okay? So let me go the replenishment quantity 70, click here. Everything is a touchless. It's amazing functionality. You see here, this is the one. The request 2005 requested. It means that there are multiple statuses which I have gone through some document. The Oracle seeded document is there. The submitted means the supplier submitted. Requested means the requisition is approved and created, but your purchase order is not yet created and associated with the requisition number. So this is a indication. So that's how I'm seeing here. My order status is right now is requested. Means the requisition got created, but the purchase order not created. If you have created a blanket purchase agreement for this part number, then what will happen once you click the replenish, create a replenishment request, automatically may be created a purchase order. So immediately, if the purchase order is created, not yet approved, it will be in review. If it's purchase order is created, approved, it will be closed, right? These are the statuses. This document is already exist in this Oracle docs.oracle.com. You can just search like a vendor manage inventory document. It will show you detailed process. Then go back here and then I log in as my vendor buy. This is a SEM00 instructor. It's a buying organization guy. You go back again the purchase orders. You want to see what is the requisition number for that. Go to purchasing and go back here. There is something like purchase orders, right? Click the purchase orders and go to taskbar, something called like a process requisitions. This is the place where you can see any requisition which is interfaced from other modules, like a planning, or it may come from min-max inventory module, it may come, sometimes it may come from life systems, or it may come from a VMI system, or sometimes it may come from order management. So any requisitions which is approved but not yet turned back to purchase order, those requisitions can be reviewed from process requisitions, right? So go to process requisitions and I don't want to give this buyer. I'll give my item, right? S21 BMI item 2. Item 2, search. So this is my requisition number, 602570 is my requisition number. I note it down here. Then go and add to document builder. It means auto create functionality in EBS. So make sure that everything is looks good. And then you go to new order, click OK. This is straightforward. And go back down, create. So I have given already pre-request unlimited approval to SEM00 instructors. So the PO got created. This is my PO number, right? So I'll give my PO number here. I'll not on my way. Now we'll go into the supplier side. We'll see what is the status, right? So I'll go back here, search. Go down, let's see. So it may take a save and close. I'll go back here. First, let me see the request replenishment. Before it, previously it was in requester status. You see, in review, this is how this document is completely explaining. I created a purchase order, but not yet approved. That's an in review status, right? This in review status. Now I'll go and see here. Got done. There are two screens here. One is vendor management request. The request, you can see the status, and this inventory also, you can, the vendor manage inventory also, they can see it here. So still it's in replenishment quantity, still not yet, the PO is not yet approved. Once the PO is approved, it will show 0 to 70. It will show as a replenishment quantity is 0. So let me approve the PO, go back again, PO screen. Before approving, let me validate this. Okay, validate actions, validate. This is again the one of the new feature which just came in the cloud. Before approving, you can see the validation, the PO will never get stuck anywhere in the interface. So it's telling that enter a value for the variable insurance amount in the class LC021 insurance. So it's nothing but there's some existing terms. I mean, the procurement contracts got attached to this agreement. I mean, this purchase order, this is Oracle standard one. So what I can do means the pending variables, you can see and click here. So I'll give my insurance values 100K. Click OK. And save. So it gone, the pending variable value is gone now. Go to actions, validate. Excellent, no errors. And if you want to see the approvals where it's flowing, you can go manage approvals. So this application, so self approval, right? Submit. So once you submit, wait for a couple of minutes. So the system will trigger, initiate, it will initiate for approval process, and then we will validate this, whether this, I'm sorry, not here. Go back again, the manage orders. I just want to see my purchase order status, it should be approved. So I'll give my order number here. This is my order number. I'm not giving my buyer details. So this is my procurement business unit, which I have taken. I already clearly told that I'm taking all my existing org structures. I'm not creating any new things. Search. Pending approval, right? So click this document number. Even if it's an in process, you can able to open here. But in EBS, if the PO is in process, you can't able to open. System will not allow you to do that. So you see, still is pending here. So I think it's got approved now. I'm going a little bit past because I have limited time to explain this functionality, but if you people have got any doubt anytime, please contact to me. So I'll ready to help your people's got open. My name is Subramanian Jairam. My email ID is subbuj1978@gmail.com. Right? So it open means it's approved. Now I'll go back again here. I'll query my, first I'll go and see my request set. Like a replenishment request. Once you go for replenishment request, give this item S22, S21, BMI, item 2. Right? So click search. See? Closed. So it's exactly everything is flowing as per my the Oracle CDA document, which I have read this user guide. So it's closed. Now I'll go back again, done, go back to my inventory. I want to see my inventory status, what is that, right? So here, not here, I'm sorry, here, done, manage inventory. Here is another place you can see, or if you see here also, orders opened to replenishment request in process 3, everything you can click here, you can see here. So you just click here, orders open. This is the vision again, it'll be a little bit slow. So these are the orders. The one which I already created, 81 is my new order number. This is my 81 is my new order number, right? So click done. go back again the inventory screen, manage inventory. You can see here the purchase order quantity moved to 70 now. You see 70 quantity. Even you can click this 70 quantity here, you can see that purchase order number. If the purchase order quantity is showing is 70, if the supplier want to see what are the PO numbers for the 70 quantity or 80 quantity or multiple POs also sometimes, you click this 70, it will take you into this PO number. See, this is my PO number, complete purchase order quantity, in transit 0, received 0. And when it got created and when it's promised. And what is the organization, everything will show here. This is the amazing functionality which I'm seeing in the cloud, right? So now this 70 quantity, the PO is approved, buyer is agreed, everything, hey, ship it. I'm approved the PO. Now I'm going to create a ASN, advanced shipment notice, as a supplier. You see here, Jamie Ryan is the supplier contact person. The supplier is going to create a ASN for this. Keep the cursor here, go to actions, create ASN. So select, click ASN, create ASN. And if you have right times this, again, the shipment number is like S21 shipment, ship one. Like I'm giving some easy way. And if you have packing slip, everything, this is the same in the receiving form, which we are seeing in our EBS or in cloud receiving form. And how much quantity you're going to ship. This is my order quantity 70. I'm going to total quantity 70 quantity. Or you can go for a partial quantity also, right? So submit. So ASN S21 ship on was created. Done. Again, go back here. Search. Go down. This is my item, VMI item 2, right? So go back here. You can see in transit quantity, right? Because the ASN is created, the ASN is in flowing from buying organization to the vendor to buying organization in transit quantity. You see how comfortable, how seamless integration between the supplier portal and then the buying organization. You can see everything in one screen, right? But in Oracle EBS, if you want to see this way, you have a vendor in transit inventory report in inventory model. You have to run that, you have to give parameters, you have to open that. That's again the text file. You can't able to filter it. Very difficult. Yes, very simple. And if you want to see this quantity again, click the 70, it will show you your ASN number. You see, this is my shipment number. So what you can do means you take this number, the shipment number, go to inventory, you can receive it. Click here. I'm going to the inventory module. I'm buying organization, CM00 instructor is my buyer, right? So I'm going here, I'm going to supply chain execution, inventory. So you need to change this organization, right? So receipts, receive expected shipments. So 001, I'm going to HC01 is my inventory org. I think I have given access for this guy. 01, HC01, click OK. Go here, receive expected shipments. And you can give your ASN number here. Click search. Click here, receive. So how much? 70 I'm going to receive. And again, this is my inventory destination type. I'm going to put it in my somewhere in the stores. Right? And create receipt. Locator. Yeah, This is the locator control, this subentry. I don't know the locator name. Let me take in the different subentry, which is not locator control. Something like shipping. Yeah, shipping is not a locator control. Great. Just submit. My main intention here, not this receiving process or purchasing process. I want to show how vendor manage inventory will work. So this is my receipt number. I'll keep my receipt number here. And now I am going back to my vendor managed inventory. Go here, done. And go back search. You see here, on hand is showing is 70 because I already received on hand showing 70. Excuse me, 70. And if you don't, nothing is, this is minimum quantity, maximum quantity. Again, sometime later, again, after 1 week, the buyer is asking, hey, I have 50 quantity. Still, I have 50 quantity. I can able to ship you. Shall I do it? Yes, please. So go action, create replenishment request. And give the supply site, operate. And I'll go for a 50 quantity, right? Submit. Now you see, great. This is my a line, right? This is my 100 quantity. So if it is crossed, 100 quantity is 120. If it is crossed, minimum quantity will show as a green. Now you can see here 70 is my on hand, 50 is in replenishment quantity. Again, the same process, you have to go and do the receiving process. You have to process the requisition, create approve the PO and receive it. Again, it will come back. Again, you can try multiple scenarios, like you can return the requisition back to the supplier and the status will show as a failed, or you canceled. If any errors, it will fail. Or if you created a PO and buyer thought that you want to cancel the PO, you cancel the PO, it will show as a cancel. These are the status all will come in this replenishment request statuses. Okay. So any questions, please contact me. My name is Subbu. I can able to help you as much as possible, whatever, wherever you get stuck. And later, I think I plan to explain the contract manufacturing replenishment process, how it will work. Okay. Have a nice day. Thank you.